save countless lines of code with animations in Godot. Here's your typical gun, shooting bullets when the player clicks. You can do it all with code, and it looks like this. Or, in Godot, you can use an animation instead and save at least 15 lines of code. When a bullet hits its target, you need to stop it from moving, turn off its collisions, play some sound, trigger particles, and remove it from the scene. This animation does just that, with a big advantage over code that you can tweak the timing of everything with ease. Let's go back to the beginning and see how to make the simpler animation-based bullet. Here's our bullet scene. It's an area 2D with a circle collision-shaped 2D that detects when it hits something. We added a particles 2D and an audio stream player 2D for juice. In the script, every frame we move the bullet in a fixed direction. Everything else happens in the animation, because in Godot you can change any property and call any function using animations. We just need to connect the body entered signal of our area to a function that starts the animation. To animate the impact, we create an animation player node. In the animation bottom panel, we add an animation. We need to call two functions on the root bullet node, as well as one on the collision shape. To do so, we're going to create a call function track for each. Turn off physics process by calling set physics process false in the function track on the bullet to stop it moving. Queue free the collision shape in its function track to stop it colliding. Set emitting to true on your particles for the collision. Play the sound of the bullet hitting its mark. To do that, we add an audio stream player, drag and drop our sound into the audio stream, and key in playing the sound so that we can see its waveform. Then, hide the bullet sprite and queue free the bullet at the end of the sound with its call function track. Using animations is great. Changing the timings of everything is a breeze, saving you time jumping around scripts. You can drag sounds around the timeline and match your animations perfectly. You don't need all those timers, signals, and calls to yield. And as a result, your scripts are shorter, easier to read, and easier to debug. You can use the exact same tricks in 3D. This airstrike is all animation. We do even more than with the bullet. We animate the color and shape of the cylinder to turn it into a thick beam. We use a call function track to play particles and damage the target. And thanks to the animation, we get away with having only a tiny amount of code. We can easily add to the sound, the same as before, adding an audio stream player, dragging and dropping the sound files, and enabling the playing property on the audio stream in our animation. We use this technique to simplify our code constantly. You can use it for weapons, explosions, and so much more. We cover all those in Godot Node Essentials, the ultimate Godot cookbook. You can get four big guides from Node Essentials for free, including this kick-ass airstrike. Just click the link in the description, enter your email, and you'll get one big guide every day for 4 days. Be creative, have fun, and see you in the next one. Bye-bye.